Hello and welcome. In this video tutorial, I'm going to introduce the conditional operator in Java. I'm going to explain exactly how it works, and I'm going to illustrate it with a very clear example. Let me begin by motivating why we would use the conditional operator. So I have a very simple program here called Conditional Operator Demo. It consists of a simple main method, and I've initialized the variable a to be minus 10. And the whole point of this program is to compute the absolute value of this variable a. So a is initialized to 10, as we said. We declare a variable called abs absolute value. It's an integer. And then we simply check if a is greater than 0, then the absolute value of a is equal to a, because it's positive. Recall that the absolute value of a number is the positive representation of that. The absolute value of an integer, I beg your pardon, is a positive representation of that integer. So an integer can be either a positive or a negative number or zero. So the absolute value of minus 10 would be 10. So if a is greater than zero, which means it's already positive, the absolute value is simply equal to a. If a is not greater than zero, by definition, it must be either zero or negative. And we say the absolute value is minus a. So if it's less than zero, minus minus is plus, this will return a positive number. And if it's zero itself, well, minus zero and plus zero are the same. So bottom line, these four lines, these five lines, I beg your pardon, determine the absolute value of an integer. I can now introduce the conditional operator in Java. So here it is. The first thing I can tell you about the conditional operator is that this one line of code allows us to replace the following six lines of code. So that's the first characteristic, if you like, of the conditional operator. It allows us to express more coherently and more concisely functionality that we wish to provide. So what exactly is the conditional operator in Java? Well, let's have a look at this expression, this conditional operator. It consists of three parts. The first part is the conditional expression. Let me just put a clear line between us. There's a conditional expression, and this expression always evaluates to either true or false. So this is identical to the conditional expression we have up here. So that's the first part. The second part is always followed by, it always comes after the question mark. So the second part is an expression or variable that comes after a question mark. And this is the value that is returned returned from the conditional operator when the conditional expression evaluates to true. So this value here is returned from the conditional operator when the conditional expression evaluates to true. And lastly, the third part is the expression or value that is returned when the conditional operator evaluates to false. And the expression or variable that is returned when a conditional expression evaluates to false always comes after the colon. So in simple English, we have our conditional expression here. We have the result that is returned when the conditional expression is true is here, and the result that is returned when the conditional expression is false is here. So let me show you an example, illustrate with an example. So I shall comment out the code that we no longer need. So we have declared int a is equal to 10. Then the next line of code, the green code is commented out, is the absolute value is equal to the following conditional operator. The conditional expression a greater than 0, well, is a greater than 0? Is 10 greater than 0? Yes, it is. Hence, it evaluates to true. Hence, we return the value that comes immediately after the question mark. We return a. So int absolute value is equal to a. Int absolute value is equal to 10, and we print out, it'll print out 10. So let me demonstrate. Compile and run, and it prints out 10. That is correct. Okay, let me demonstrate with minus 10. Now, let's have a look again. Our conditional expression a greater than 0, is that true or false? Well, minus 10 is not greater than 0. Therefore, the conditional expression evaluates to false. Hence, it returns minus a, the false expression or value that comes immediately after the colon. So int absolute value is equal to minus a, is equal to minus minus 10, which is plus 10. Hence, it'll print out plus 10, which of course is the absolute value what we're looking for. So compile and run, and it prints out 10, which is correct. So that's exactly what the conditional operator is. We can now simply take these lines of code and delete them. And as you can see, we have much shorter, much more concise, much more easily readable code. I know you might say, the first time you see this, you might say, okay, Martin, this is not easily readable. But trust me, you'll get used to it very quickly. It just consists, the conditional operator consists of three parts. The first part is the conditional expression. The second part is the value that is returned when the conditional expression is true. And the third part is the value that is returned when the conditional expression is false. That's it. That's all there is to it. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any feedback or comments, please leave them in the comment section. Thank you very much.